Jordan Stahl, Maxim Talbot, and Tyler Kennedy begin for the Penguins with Brooks Orpik and Sergei Gonchar on defense against Mike Richards, Scott Hartnell, and Daniel Briere, with Timo Tiiminen starting the game on defense and Randy Jones. Kennedy brings it on. Kennedy, the first shot blocked off by Biron. Sent back along for the control of Jordan Stahl. Brought back by Briere, carried on by Richards. And Richards a shot, and that one whistled wide and bounced over near Talbot. Tripped up a bit by Daniel Briere, but it's controlled and feathered back to the blue line, out and then in. Should it be Pittsburgh and Detroit in the final, you would have two of the older arenas in the lead. This is a backhander in front by Briere that's geared away and taken on by Jarkko Ruutu. Lobbed ahead now for Stahl. Most impressive in game four for Pittsburgh. He put that one into the catching glove of Biron. The big winger centered one in front, and it deflected off a stick and is corralled and started along but not out. Laurent Wall to the half boards, and a penalty coming up. It'll be against the Flyers. First power play of the game to the Penguins.
It's going to be on Mike Knobel. So energy coming from the fourth line.
The Penguins overall in the series are 3-for-14 on the power play. That is subpar for them. And over the games in Philadelphia, only 1-for-6. Crosby a drive to flip and score! Malone! Little pass on to Sidney Crosby. Backhander is turned aside by Biron. Pulled up through traffic or not?
I guess once you take that hesitation, Doc, it's probably too late, so you just got to react right away, and if not, you got to just keep going.
Carter a shot, bounced loose off of Fleury, but came wide, and then it's fed out for a shot by Upshaw, and Fleury got that one, and it's cleared off a stick and back down, but they rule that it will be an icing touch-up, and the fans don't like that. Back in, Mike Komisarek, Christopher Higgins, also NHLers that have come from that area. Brought back ahead now by Richards, able to pull away from one, up the wing, gaining it as Hartnell, and Hartnell dips the shoulder and fed, hoping for Richards, a backhander, is covered by Fleury. Darren Etcher gave it on now to Upshaw, backhands one that had to be turned aside by Fleury as it went through a moving screen set up by Carter. Onto the back now, Perrin a shot, and that one went wide. So on at center, Richards got it, nearly gave it up, and did to Malone. Follow-up now comes across to Sikora. Return to Malone, and a shot save, Biron! That's a lot of work. A lot of work early. Important work as Dupuis' shot is blocked off. Rebound! Oh, and sliding across to block it, and then tumbling to the ice was Richards.
Tremendous effort there by Sidney Crosby. The explosion to try to get that loose puck. Good defense there by the Flyers. There's a wide open net in behind the line.
Steal by Hossa. Down to the ice of Flyers. He tried to pull his way through, and that was Tiiminen, who's back to his feet. Scuderi ahead. Back around to Biron. Played it away from Malone. Near Malkin, back to Malone.
No Victor Biron.
Uh-oh, out in front. Score! Malkin!
Push all the right buttons for Michael Therrien and the Penguins.
Sikora shot, pad stop, Biron rebound, and he's able to hang on to it.
Keep him there, prevent him, keep an arm's length away so he doesn't get to the front of the net like that, the most dangerous area.
Sent down was Smith by Ruutu, and the Roo chant goes up as a feed is in front, and a shot went off of a stick, and is brought back ahead by Richards.
Some good control on the Flyers' power play there, but nothing to show for it.
They are standing in the last 2 seconds. Out of play, but the period ended. 15 shots, two-thirds of them by Pittsburgh, and they got both goals. Hartnell will work up front. Richards will probably take a point. Briere will hope for that quick pass across in the stash in that worked so well in the Montreal series. Hartnell will be the big presence. Lupul is the other forward to join them. The pass comes on to Lupul, fires, and that one turned aside, and then trickled on back for Richards, plays it back safely to Briere, hands it on now for Tiiminen. Tiiminen across to Richards again. Richards across. Briere a shot, pad stop, rebound, another stop made by Fleury. Bang, bang, play, and he got them both. Sent back across now for Lassi Kukkonen. Pass went off a Pittsburgh stick. And it's protected by Gonchar. Squibby pass off the boards. Took a crazy bounce. Right back over and denied away from Richards by the work of Crosby. Taken on by Talbot. Pass was away from Hossa. Brought on by Crosby. Sent by Hossa to Crosby again to Hossa. Score! To the point, Brooks Orpik with it there. Driven into the catching glove of Giron by Gonchar. Briere roughed up a bit by Brooks Orpik. One of the leading hitters in the league in the regular season and the leader for Pittsburgh in these playoffs. Carried back out by Orpik. Boston College product got it ahead, gave to Malone, and the shot was turned aside by Giron.
I think Orpik might even got a piece of that, Doc, on the redirect. Good stop there by Giron.
And a pass is on the money for Briere, and the big drive is off Orpik and up into the bag. Malkin just pulls around from the outside, feeds it back to Ryan Whitney. Full strength, drive by Malkin, shrugged away as it ricocheted back in near Biron. Malkin again fakes the drive and pirouettes away from Carter. Right back into traffic, tripped up, penalty call. Jeff Carter to the box, another power play for the Penguins. Malone and Hossa, the wingers. Gonchar and Malkin, the point men. Lots of potential there as it's held by Sidney Crosby. Given back on for Hossa. Battling at the front is Malone. A shot by Gonchar. Score! Malone again! 4-0! Hossa to the outside to Dupuy, and his shot went off Jason Smith. Played back along for Hossa to take it. Speared by Smith, and he stays down. And the puck came back to center, and this is a break now for Upshaw. Upshaw moving in, and it's denied from behind. Dupuy just now going over the boards after having been shaken up. One of the better flyer opportunities of the day just a moment ago.
Yeah, the puck was rolling on Upshaw. Outstanding job there by Rob Scuderi to come back, not take a penalty. Getting some help from the backside as well. It's really noticeable for the Penguins is that that's good support with the puck carrier. Never isolated one-on-one, one-on-twos. Always two-on-ones, three-on-twos. Saved there by Marty Biron.
Then this year, an altogether different story and an altogether different team. As Thorsson got it across and the shot is blocked away by Fleury. A blast by Mike Knubel. And it takes a Pittsburgh bounce right across now for the carry by Ryan Whitney. Jeff Carter on this faceoff that is won by the Penguins and given over to Brooks Orpik. So many of the players on both of these teams have played in the Junior Championships of Canada, the Memorial Cup, and that is going on now in Kitchener, Ontario. A walk out in front and a shot by Stahl and a backhander. He scores! 5-0. To go in the second. Biron out to hustle that on now for Jason Smith as they are making a change in lines for one last shift. The Penguins are brought on by Thorsson. Gives to Jim Dowd, and Dowd threw one that ricocheted around and in, and it is ruled no goal. A centering toss by Jim Dowd went into the cage to see if there's any reason that this should be overruled, but it is ruled no goal. Boy, I could not tell from that.
It looked like a pretty good goal to me. They crashed in it. It looked like it went off the leg, Doc, but I'd have to take a different look at it. They certainly will get it upstairs.
Was this kicked in? Take a look. Distinct kicking motion is one thing that has to happen. Let's look one more time here at the two players at the front of the net. And by then, it is up on the arm of Fleury and directed in, it looks as though, by Philadelphia Flyers in their 99th game of meaning this year, wanting it to not be the last one, but it's against very tall odds against a team that has been so strong defensively in Pittsburgh. Marc-Andre Fleury played it ahead. Hartnell turnaround shot saved by Fleury. Sent aside by the defense and taken back on by Kennedy. Laid back on for Jordan Staal. Banked it right back in, and around it swirled to Biron. Whipped it away with a big goal stick, and up the boards it comes back to Brooks Orpik.
Biron was going in behind the net. He thought the puck was going to go around. He left his net, and puck never made it there. And then Talbot, with that good opportunity, got knocked down. Trying to cheat a little bit, Biron, from his goaltending crease.
Maxim Talbot will probably be remembered in this, what appears to be a Penguins rush to the final, as the fourth centerman. Oh, what a goal that time by Hossa. Breaking to the net was Dupuis, and he may have gotten a piece of it. Back-to-back Stanley Cups. And many players always talk about the fact you just think they're going to come more often because they came very quickly. Same happened with the Flyers. This is carried back in by Prospel, and his shot is stopped and held by Fleury.
Dead last year in the National Hockey League, and here they are, three wins away from getting to the Stanley Cup Finals. Tremendous job all the way around. It all started with Paul Holmgren.
Here's Carter, a shot, and a pat stop is made by Fleury with a little over 9.5 to go in this.
You can see down here, guys, the sense of inevitable amongst the Philadelphia Flyers players. As good a season as it's been, it's still tough to finish with a loss.
Scorching shot by Whitney was patted by Biron. Off the Atlanta Thrashers back in Philadelphia, and the rest of their season took an upward turn.
With Antero Nedomaki as your goaltender in that game.
You're right. Oh, a shot off the pipe from Rob Scuderi has the crowd buzzing.
Ty Conklin came in and just did a phenomenal job of giving this team an opportunity to be in every game with consistent goaltending.
That's a great point, Edzo. It was Ryan Malone that had him as the team MVP during that stretch.
Should be 6-1, but for Fleury, denying Carter.
He made that beautiful pass to Hossa to the short side. There was a soft goal given up by Marty Biron, and he showed the big save by Fleury. That's where the Flyers needed a big stop there from Biron.
Boy, just complete turnovers by the Flyers, but the Penguins just pressing and pressing, and Biron was able to hold Kwong in a three-shot combination. Now Gonchar, that one is swept angrily back out by Mike Richards, who comes to the bench for another change, and 3:50 left. Centering pass came back out. A chance for Kukkonen, and Kukkonen has drawn a penalty to the Penguins with a minute and 40 seconds to go. And the fans here are all standing. They have sat during the entire game, stood only when necessary, and now they think it's necessary, and why not? Not urged on by any scoreboard, they're just saluting their team for another thrilling afternoon. That one is held by Fleury. 23 left. Prospel brings it on and drops to Umberger. That one came around in front, denied by Gill and cleared. Marc-Andre Fleury will have his third shutout. And the Penguins will be in the Stanley Cup Final for the first time since 1992. Coaches that have waged a war of bench jockeying and all of the things you have to think about as a coach, shake hands after having met for the 52nd time, and they're both still young men. Confetti raining down here at Mellon Arena as the Flyers patiently, politely wait for the celebration by the Penguins, and then the old routine that is known only to this sport. All of it melts in handshakes at center ice. Rob Scuderi is the first to offer his hand of congratulations as you see Talbot and Fleury, and they proceed through the line. Evgeny Malkin was a target. He was worked over pretty thoroughly. The question was, with Pittsburgh got through this series, how healthy would they be going into the final? Pretty healthy. Sidney Crosby getting congratulations.
It was a player, a marquee player along with Sidney Crosby, you know. And when teams challenge those types of players, Doc, they want to see the reaction. Is the guy going to fall and not fight back? And not from a sense of dropping the gloves, but how is he going to compete? And you use it as a strategy to try and get under the skin and make it difficult. And you have to target those guys. Because if you allow guys like Crosby, like Malkin, room out there, they're going to make you pay. And you're not going to shut those guys down. You like to limit their opportunities. And you have to be hard on the body.
Marty Biron, what a gallant performer he was through these playoffs, fashioning a playoff reputation of his own here in winning two series. Bill Daly, the deputy commissioner of the National Hockey League, is going to present the Prince of Wales Trophy to Sidney Crosby. That's a polite distance, isn't it?
Respectfully to Bill Daly.
Yes. It'll be here for you when you want it. Somebody else will carry it off. So Sid the Kid captained this team through three rounds of the playoffs now, and Marc-Andre Fleury with a huge grin on his face. At only age 23, he has backstopped his team into the Stanley Cup final. And today, 21 he faced, 21 he got in his third shutout of a very brief career when it comes to being in the playoffs.
Well, if there's any doubt, we talked about Marty Turco a little bit earlier, Doc. Marc-Andre Fleury, the first pick overall in the 2003 entry draft, the Pittsburgh Penguins, then general manager Craig Patrick, who deserves a lot of credit with his staff, Mark Kelly, Greg Malone, and now with the new regime here with Ray Sherrow and Chuck Fletcher, drafting Brooks Orpik, Scuderi, Whitney, Letang, Malkin, Crosby, Malone, Talbot, you can go on and on. But the ability to be able to be patient, have a plan, stay with it. But Marc-Andre Fleury, no doubt, has had the ability, but you have to have patience. And he has given the Pittsburgh Penguins consistency. And contrary to what a lot of people have said and believe, he was not rushed to the National Hockey League. There was patience in his first year, 9 games his rookie year. The next year, there was no National Hockey League. The third year, he didn't come up until the end of January. So that is not rushing a young player, especially a goaltender. Last year, 40 wins, the Penguins making the playoffs, and now getting to the Stanley Cup final 5 years later after a young goaltender that was drafted number 1 overall back in 2003, Marc-Andre Fleury.